y'all are close in the second half, and this takes away from you. That happened a lot last year. What do you
I mean, I know last year there was a young team, lack of depth, but what do you think has caused these kind of second half saves against some of the top teams?
It's hard to say. You know, some things just didn't go our way, and I just felt as a team we didn't react well. That's really part of the game. You know, things don't go our way all the time. It's just kind of how you react to those things, and I just kind of think we just didn't handle it the correct way.
How can you work on correcting that? I mean, obviously, y'all have a pretty big gauntlet coming up ahead. How do you correct that?
You got to just keep practicing hard. You got to watch the film. You got to go back and see where the breakdowns occur and how we can kind of prevent those things when you put us in them situations. So it just really goes all the way back to practice, film, just doing what we've, you know, been coached to do, really.
How confident are you can kind of turn this around next time it happens? You have a close, tight game in the second half like that.
I'm pretty confident because I'm sure we're going to learn from this film like we've been doing, and we're going to give ourselves a better chance not to even get put in situations like that, to kind of just go ahead and put the foot down and keep rolling. Because, you know, we came out, had a good drive, but then we kind of just lost it a little bit once adversity hit us. So we want to just kind of, I guess you could say, be proactive about letting that even happen before it even gets started.
When that adversity hit, did you think y'all would respond better?
I thought we would. Because it's something that we've been through before. You know, it's been something that happened to us. And, you know, they just had some real good things go well for them at the right time. And, you know, a lot of guys just kind of didn't know how to handle it. You know, it was some of those guys just been here 2 years, but, you know, some of the older guys kind of knew what to do, but it was hard to come back once everybody kind of just lost it and didn't know what to do. It was kind of like everybody just got real frustrated and flustered.
Did you sense that Florida gained confidence as the game went in that second half?
Yeah, you can tell once they hit the big play, the 80-yarder, and they kind of just really got into the offensive rhythm.
Coach Dooley said that he should have substituted the skilled players a little bit more, including you. Did you feel like you needed a break or that have helped you?
I felt well. You know, I really wanted to win at any cost, so if substituting me was going to, you know, help that and turn the game around, I was all for it. But I felt pretty well and felt that I was, you know, productive and, you know, definitely continued to be productive when called.
You said that you didn't feel like that the adversity was handled that well. Then you've got some adversity coming off a loss and then going to face Akron. How confident are you that this team will bounce back?
I'm pretty confident, man. Coach Dooley's been really, you know, giving us inspirational talks, talking to us individually, giving us, you know, a bunch of words before practice, definitely in our meetings and yesterday. He's really making everybody stay up, you know, leave it in the past. And we had a good day of practice today, so I feel everybody kind of, you know, let it go, move on, because we got a long season ahead of us.
Was it better than Monday's practice?
Oh, yeah, definitely. Because I want to say before we even started, he brought the whole team together and just gave us some words. And you can kind of see everybody got up a little bit, and then we all did our little chants and all that stuff. So it was a good practice. A lot of high energy guys rolling around, so we're ready to get back to work.
How did you think you played against Florida?
I feel I did all right, you know, still room for improvement, but I feel I was productive and did what was asked of me when called up.
When you go back and look at film, do you and grade yourself, do you feel like, you know, you're getting all the yards you could out of each run, or are there things you feel like you're losing some yards on the field? How do you assess that?
Majority of them I felt I got what I could. It was some where I, you know, kind of got shoestring tackle, just getting excited, getting out there in the open field, but you know, it's never a perfect game, and it was things I still seen that I need to work on, and I feel that'll just, you know, come with time and definitely help us win more games.
Where's the fine line between, you know, learning from what happened against Florida but dwelling on it and not dwelling on it too much? How do you, you know, focus on fixing the kind of things that went wrong there and not, you know, but not think too much about it?
You just got to really dissect the film. You got to just pay attention, take coaching, and move on. Go practice hard, get into this next install and game plan, and just keep moving.
Is it tough for y'all sometimes? It seemed like, you know, especially when Tyler got really frustrated there in the fourth quarter, he's not a guy that had done that very often. How different was that to see so much frustration out of him? Because he's normally a guy that kind of lets it go in one ear, not the other.
It was different, but you can just tell the passion that he was playing with. You can just tell how bad he wanted to win. So it wasn't more or less we was just mad at how frustrated he was. We can just tell he wanted it so bad that it just kind of got the best of him. And I feel it did that to a lot of us.
Well, there have been people in the past who said he hadn't cared enough, so I guess it's just it's a little better to care maybe too much than not care enough, isn't it?
Yeah, definitely. But, you know, it's an emotional game. You know, these guys are hungry for wins, you know, definitely coming off what we did last year. So I just feel the hunger to win just really took over and really just had a lot of guys frustrated when things didn't go our way.
Rajon, you obviously you had to be pretty happy with the performance. I know it was in a loss, but you know, it seemed like you were really running north and south and getting the yards you could.
Yeah,
is that how you kind of, when you went back and watched it, is that how you felt?
Yeah, I was happy with my performance, but be honest, at the end of the day, I wanted to win so bad. I could have had 2 yards and I would have been just as happy. But, you know, I want to do everything I can on my half to help this team be successful and win.
You mentioned Tyler wanting to win so bad. Can you kind of tell when he starts maybe pressing it, you know, he starts trying to do things that, you know, maybe trying to go for the home run ball as opposed to, you know, just taking what's given to him?
Yeah, you can tell, but that's just the competitive nature, man. You know, guy's a winner. He got confidence in our receivers. We got confidence in him. He knows we behind him and believe in everything that he does. So, yeah, he took shots and, you know, kind of tried to press things that really wasn't there, but it was just the competitive nature and just the willing to want to win. So we was behind him 100%.
Last couple weeks, I mean, Western Kentucky's beaten an SEC team. Louisiana Monroe's played well against SEC teams. Bowling Green from the MAC played Florida tough. How much have the coaches been kind of talking about that and try to make sure y'all avoid a letdown this week, or has it been brought up at all?
I think every week they just tell you, you can't take nobody for granted. You got to go out here and have good days of practice, and it starts, you know, Sunday after the game, man. You can't look past nobody, and you can't, you know, dwell on the past. So it's been sad to us, but at the same time, we treat everybody the same. We come out prepared and work hard, and, you know, we fight to win every game.
Well, this will be just a few tough game last week, big games coming up. How much has focus been an issue this week? Has that been a problem or not?
No, it's real early in the week, and Coach Dooley's really been doing a great job at staying in our heads and keeping us, you know, right on that path of, you know, getting over the loss, staying focused, and just having a good week of practice.
How much better have you guys done this year getting over the Florida loss, maybe than say last year, where did it stick with you a little bit longer last season?
Yeah, I feel it did, because it was a lot of things that went wrong with losing Justin and, you know, guys kind of, you know, doing separate things on their own. But, you know, I feel this year, man, we got a great chemistry. Coach Dooley's doing a real big job at, you know, having these coaches stay up under us and, you know, just coach us and be there for us. And, you know, they're talking to us. They're making sure that we're not sitting back, you know, dwelling and just sitting around here acting like the world's over. So they're doing a great job of just standing around us and keeping us positive.